one-day cricket, you can take away the likelihood of a bouncer. That's something, of course, which in Test cricket or first-class cricket might be of some concern. Nonetheless, there does come a time where the fairness of the match, the batsman has to be given just a reasonable chance to sight the ball. And George Sharp and Kenny Palmer at the end of that very quick over, very quick maiden as it turns out, have now met to discuss what happens next. And fair's fair, they've gone to the batsman, offered them the lights, and that wasn't a contest, I promise you, in the minds of Dominic Cork and Carl Cricken.
Well, they came back on for a few minutes and they added 7 runs, but then it clouded over again and it was called off for the day. That's how the Derbyshire card reads. Wonderful start, 70 for the first wicket, Slater and Barnett. Then that awful collapse, 7 wickets falling for 11 runs off 51 balls. Wonderful bowling. Once the Lancashire bowlers settled and got their line and length, there's plenty of movement out there for Peter Martin. 4 for 19. He took 4 for 4 of 23 balls in that collapse. And Ian Austin, never far from the action, 10 overs, 5 maidens, 3 for 14.
If you're tuning in for our film comedy Runaway Heart, it can now be seen at the later time of 10 past 1. And that's to make way for something extra on BBC One. Highlights of today's extended cricket final between Lancashire and Derbyshire. Introduced by Tony Lewis.
After winning the all-important toss yesterday, Lancashire seamers took full advantage of the helpful conditions. They put their side firmly in control. Peter Martin with 4 wickets and Ian Austin with 3 reduced Derbyshire to 92 for 7. And that was before bad light forced the teams off the field. Now, Derbyshire's hopes of a respectable total seem now to depend on their captain, Dominic Cork. Well, hello and welcome to the highlights of this second day of the NatWest Trophy final. Lancashire versus Derbyshire. It's often said that if you win the toss, put the other side in, then you've got a really good chance of winning the match. But in fact, play didn't start until late afternoon. Still, they were sweating and there was seaming of the ball, and Derbyshire got themselves into real trouble. Let's take a look at their scorecard. Good opening partnership by Slater and Barnett of 70, but then the seamers got really well on top. And just look there, 70 for the first wicket, 19 extras, and 92 for 7. That was the state at the end of the first day. And the bowling, the best bowling by Peter Martin, absolutely on the spot, 9 overs, 4 for 19, and Ian Austin, 10 overs, 5 maidens, 3 for 14. Well, after sweating under the covers a bit, the pitch did help the seam bowlers, we saw that. There was also the suspicion that juice in the pitch wouldn't leave immediately. Let's check out the state of the pitch on the second day with David Gower.
Well, as expected yesterday, this pitch did plenty to help the seam bowlers. And there's one very good reason for that. If you feel the grass, there's plenty of it on the surface here, nicely rolled in, but if you feel it, it's moist. There's plenty of juice left in there. That's what helped the ball move around yesterday, and that's what'll help the ball do the same again today. The only hope for Derbyshire is that the juice stays in there, because they're not going to have many runs on the board, it seems, and they're going to hope that their bowlers too, later on, can get some more movement out of it. Still some juice around, still some moisture in the footmarks. That gives you a clue. It's going to be another seamer's day, I'm sure.
So a fine sunny morning meant a prompt start, and we join the action now in the third over of the day. Derbyshire have added 2 runs to their score, and Wasim Akram is bowling to Dominic Cork. Big shout, and that's out. Yeah, it obviously zipped in down the hill. We'd love a look at that again, but Wasim Akram, quick. Dominic Cork goes, caught by Hegbal Wasim off for five. The 13th ball of the morning.
Well, it's a question of whether it actually touched any part of the bat or glove on the way through. It's not very easy to tell. There's little noise, but it could have been the ball flicking the top of the pad. Dominic Cork certainly wasn't keen to leave. But that could be for any number of reasons. Well, it might just have been that little flick of the inside edge there. Vince Clark is the new man. Right-handed batsman, right-arm, brisk medium-pace bowler as well.
So 94 for 8. And I'm afraid Derbyshire's torrid time continues. Not to say, of course, that Lancashire won't get into the same sort of trouble. Another appeal for LBW. Certainly the bat made contact with the ball, but probably ball made contact with pad first or with boot.
Well, that was the reason for the appeal for certain. Good delivery, just swinging in late. And yeah, I'm sure it has made contact with the pad first. Just have to check the line out as well. All sorts of little things come into play again. That would have been smacking leg stump out of the ground. Big smile on Vince Clark's face immediately afterwards. That means nothing, of course. Could just be relief at surviving that first ball.
That's called fear.
You're a hard man.
Contact with the bat and a good positive stroke, and that's a lovely boundary. Backward square on the offside. Wasim just offering that little bit of width.
Well, why not? As far as Vince Clark is concerned, room to swing the bat. One hand came off it. The ball sped to the boundary. And every run at this stage precious for Derbyshire.
Lovely shot, well played again. Two successive fours off Wasim Akram. Wasim pitching the ball up, looking for that swing, and quite rightly so. And cheers of some relief for Derbyshire supporters as the 100 comes up. Oh, well bowled. It looked a beauty. A little nick. Automatic step for Warren Hegg behind the stumps.
Well, that expression means, what was I meant to do about that? Carl Cricken out for two. Completely opened up by the movement of the delivery. And, well, he just wants to have another look on the big screen, I think, just to see how good a delivery it was. It was aimed straight at the stumps, just pitched and moved away. Good length, good line, and all the sort of movement that you need to find the edge.
Kevin Dean is the last batsman. 102 for 9. That's Dominic Cork. He wasn't actually too happy when he was given out caught behind the wicket. Wasim Akram to Kevin Dean now. Oh, that was quite a shout. That's a wonderful four defensive stroke. He was completely out of tempo with the speed of the ball.
Well, what might have saved him is he did manage to get just enough of a stride in to get his toe outside the line of off stump, I think. Yeah, and where it strikes what could be a painful blow on the toe, that's not out. It's a good decision.
Whack. Well, actually, it's not too bright a performance by Wasim Akram, because he's been hit very hard to the offside three times in a row now, and Clark goes to 30 not out. The third man into double figures in this innings.
I think that's the shot of the innings. It's certainly the shot of the morning. That's no contest. And Vince Clark, 13 not out, making it look quite easy for now.
Man goes back at deep square leg. And over they go. Well, it was a good contest, and I think that Vince Clark can be very happy indeed that he clobbered those 13 runs. They may be very precious, who knows? Derbyshire bowled out for 108. Wassim Akram gets his man.
Inside edge. Drag the ball back onto the middle stump. Still a nice sight for any fast bowler to see the middle stump cartwheeling out of the ground. They've somehow managed to get it up to 108 before that stump went under the ground to signal the end of the innings.
Well, I'm afraid that the Derbyshire tail refused to wag, and only 16 runs were added, taking the total on to 108 all out in the 37th over. Terrific bowling by Lancashire. Really, when they get a grip on a game, they never let go. They really are experts. And as well as Peter Martin, who didn't bowl on the second day, or Ian Austin, Wassim Akram came into his own with 2 for 39, and Andy Flintoff from 3 overs, 1 maiden, 1 for 4. And so the rate required, Lancashire requiring 109 runs to win at under 2 runs an over. And we join them now in the first over. No runs have been scored, and Dominic Cork is bowling to Michael Atherton.
Well, we see plenty of these. Didn't do too much, really. It was Angus Fraser yesterday who was saying, as a bowler who bowls at Lords, you know, the slope is awkward for a lot of batsmen first up. Slope left to right on your screen, so it's helping Dominic Cork make the ball go down the slope and away. Out. Oh, should have been out. Should have been out, that. I know it went quickly, but in a low-scoring game like this, you've got to hold on to them. And especially one of the best players in the world. Michael Atherton in good touch, he's a sticker, he hangs around. But in playing away from his body, and neither went for it. That's certainly not what you want. You'd sooner them go and drop it. Oh dear.
That's not the spot to bowl. Dominic Cork's already had a word with him this over, and from the body language he was saying to him, you must keep the ball up round about off stump and don't get on the pads.
Well, I think we all know he's playing to John Crawley's strength if he bowls on the legs. He has improved on the offside, but I mean, well, he play those in his sleep. That's a good length for driving, just a bit too full. The line was okay, but the length is a juicy half volley. And Michael Atherton's beautifully onto it. Look, he's right up there. So you've got to get the line right and the length.
7 in for no wicket, Lancashire.
Wait in there.
Well fielded. The bowler got away with that because it could so easily have defeated the fieldsman and gone for 4.
That's a beauty. Now that's the one that goes away. Just a pity he gave away a 4 ball. He's got Michael playing just a bit wide. Nothing he can do as a right-hand batsman. Better, you see, full of length.
Yes, that was a good one from De Freitas. He's not in the first flush of youth. He's 33 now. Went to Australia on the last Ashes tour.
I think think this is a big test for Dominic Cork, actually. He's quite a good bowler, moves the ball around, but he's the sort of bowler who likes to try different things, to experiment a bit, and this isn't the pitch for that. Oh, that's a good shout. I don't think you'll get it, but...
That is terrifying if you're a batsman to see an umpire do this. The appeal goes up, and now you're looking up, and the next thing you see is his left arm just about to go up in the air, but doesn't go past his pocket. But oh, it would be a nasty moment. George probably gets a lot of fun out of it. That's a good half save. Saved three runs. They got the single, but it certainly would have gone for four down the hill towards the mound stand. 18 for no wicket now. Very good stroke. It was a loose delivery.
Well, it's good batting. He just played straight, nice, sensible, waited for the bad ball. As Richie said, he was bad, short, bit of width, played a classical back foot drive. That's all Lancashire have to do. They don't have to go looking for runs. Just hang about, don't make mistakes. They'll get an odd bad ball here and there. Not bothered about time, there are plenty of overs.
Nice shot, that's going to be four runs for John Crawley. Beautifully played. Still plenty of juice left in the pitch. But Lancashire have made it through so far into this 10th over without losing a wicket. They're 28 without loss. They need another 81 more runs to win this match. Beautiful delivery from Dominic Cork. That's the end of Michael Atherton. And if there's any consolation for Derbyshire, let's look back to yesterday. Think when the first wicket went down with the score on 70. Lancashire's first wicket falling on 28 to this wonderful delivery from Dominic Cork.
Well, there's never any disgrace to get out to a good ball. And he pitched about off stump and hit off stump, and when you think about the slope, it's making the ball go up the slope. I think Michael will agree that that's a quality delivery. It's fairly foolish. Michael didn't get right forward, he kind of shuffled at it a bit. It offered as if it was going to come in down the slope, but it didn't.
So now we have left-hander at the crease. Neil Fairbrother playing in a record 10th Lords final for Lancashire. Combination of NatWest finals, Benson Hedges finals. No man has done that before him. That's close. Good stride down the pitch, though, for the left-hander. Kenny Palmer turning down the appeal.
But that's the length. Batsman coming onto the front foot, and well, that was a very good shout. Straightened out a little bit. Yeah, he's a good way down, and Neil Fairbrother taking proper precautions there by stretching well outside the crease. But that's the sort of length, that's the sort of stroke they're trying to get out of the batsman. This is the forward prod.
Just slightly overpitched by Kevin Dean. Full half volley. And put away very handsomely.
Yes!
That's straight down the ground this time from Fairbrother. Closed the face a bit more this time. A roll up a little bit of a hill there over the boundary rope for four more. Thank you. four runs. First one that Philip DeFoe has really dragged too short. And the perfect opportunity for John Crawley. Perfectly placed, perfectly timed. Lancashire move on to 42 for one. Good stop. Ben Spendlove, the man at mid-off. Had a disappointing day yesterday. Out for four. And the comparison not quite as different as it was after 10 overs. Derbyshire were 56 without loss at this stage. Lancashire are 42 for one. Forget about run rates, they're not the issue today. Lancashire needing 67 more runs, Derbyshire needing 9 more wickets. And they're going to have to tumble quicker than the ruble. They're going to win this match. Great shot from Neil Fairbrother. Well, he's placed three away through the offside now. One went square. The second one went to mid-offs or past mid-offs left hand. And this one's gone through extra cover. The full range.
Well, this young bowler definitely needs some advice, and I think he's getting it. In fact, it was Michael Slater who ran across to have a word with him, because he's just charging in and over-pitching by feet. He's just practiced for the Fairbrother off-drive.
Scintillating stuff. It's a real strength of Fairbrother through the offside. But he's having far too many opportunities presented to him. Ball and wide enough to really swing the bat through the line of the ball.
Well, it's poor bowling to a man of this class. One thing a top professional player will execute to perfection is the cover drive and the off drive. Anything that's pitched up, over-pitched.
Well, maybe that's the answer. The full toss, not spotted. The half volley has been put away with monotonous regularity. Well, this is how to do it. Back on at the nursery end. Almost the perfect ball. The perfect one would have taken a wicket. That was unplayable, though. That's the antidote. Just a wee bit too short. John Crawley into the rhythm of things himself today. Hasn't missed out on any of those.
That's a good shot. Easy three there. Beautifully placed that stroke, just guided away on the offside. No great power in it, but just the placement and nice timing, just the angle of the bat. Very fine, and just a question whether it found the edge, and yes it did. That's the time at Lord's, 12:15, significant only in the sense of lunch will be taken at 12:45, but with the score at 65 for one now, needing 109 to win, the umpires can keep play going for another quarter of an hour. So you could play till 1 o'clock here if the umpires think there could be a result in that time. There's a good shot. Well, I reckon that was no more than a little gentle flick, and it's gone to the longest part of the ground for four. Superbly timed.
Well, I think most of us know that he's strong on the onside, but even so, knowing that that's his favourite side, he does time it beautifully. You have to take it a little bit on the rise, and he just caresses the ball away.
Well, that's not the way you want to be greeted when you first come on a bowl. Matthew Cassar, the new bowler from the pavilion end.
Well, he's lost none of his skill, Neil Fairbrother. I always used to delight in his batting, even from when he was a young man. Always a little bit unpredictable. Well, he's nice and straight, but you're never quite sure what shot he's going to pull out of his bag. That's what made him such a fantastic one-day cricketer through his career.
Some good shots being played out there. That was a beauty.
He's a very clever player. He played it so fine that fine leg had no chance. Little roll of the wrist, knew exactly where the fielder was. He's a very hard customer to bowl at.
78 on the board, just 1 wicket down. The partnership at the moment has reached the half century mark. John Crawley 34, Neil Fairbrother 27. A little change of field there. Dominic Cork is working on the fact that John Crawley likes that stroke away through midwicket, and he's put a man in short there, about 15 yards from the bat. And a little bit of bluff there. Put the man in at midwicket, bowl one on off stump, cutting away, and it almost worked.
Well, there's no shortage of competitive element from Dominic Cork, still trying very hard to get wickets, but it must be beginning to dawn on the players that 78 for one, Lancashire needing 109, that they're not going to manage to bowl Lancashire out unless somebody creates a miracle.
Quite a bit of blue sky around at the moment. Wishing can do a lot for one.
Yes.
Around the wicket from Dominic Cork, and that is beautifully placed by Fairbrother. No force in the stroke at all, but just deliberately guided it gently away from the left hand of the man at point.
Yes.
See, that's brilliantly played, isn't it? Just guided away from his body, just use the pace of the ball from Dominic Cork. Watching Neil Fairbrother play is a good lesson for young players, how to keep the scoreboard ticking along, and you don't have to keep hitting boundaries. He'll take the fours if he gets a ball that's a long half volley or...
Ben Spendlove is the man at point, and Fairbrother has got those two past him earlier in the over. There's some ironic cheers, but the two that went past him were so beautifully placed that it wasn't the fielder's fault that they got away from him.
Yes, one now, how many?
Well, I'm almost inclined to think Fairbrother's having a lend of him.
When we see this replay again, just watch how he opens the face. You see the back of the bat, the face is open, the ball's just run off. Didn't push at it, just let the ball run off the face.
That's another fine shot.
This is well bowled, he draws him wide. Ball leaves the bat, but I've seen him play that before. It's amazing how left-handers always seem to play and miss more than right-handers.
Steady on, Geoffrey.
Just got David Goward up from behind me, reading the paper.
Nice save. That's four. It's a good shot too. That's too short for the Kassar. But a nice stroke from Crawley.
Well, John Crawley playing and missing at a good ball, but then not missing out on a short of a length delivery. That just those two balls just about sum up the situation. Lancashire have played splendidly when they've had the opportunity to score. And Derbyshire have bowled some good balls, but no nicks.
Freitas was pursing his lips there. He reckoned it was reasonably close, but it wasn't far enough out for a wide, and it was always slanting away from the pads and the leg stump. Oh, good shot. Another one of those little flicks around on the onside from John Crawley. Nice touch.
Yes, he's not missed out on anything that he's been able to put away, which shows a man in good form, which is healthy for all England supporters, that he's going to Australia in good touch. Just a little inside edge that he kicked away. Thought it could drop near the stumps. Don't think it was going there, but instinct made him just kick the ball away.
It's four. Quite a good effort by Clark trying to get across to the catch. 100 comes up.
It's well bowled by Matthew Kassar. I rather think John Crawley was looking towards the clock and trying to finish this by 1 o'clock at lunch, so that it didn't have to come back after a long lunch. No feet here, long way away from the ball. But they know they've got it won.
Fraction outside off stump.
This ball just looked to keep it a little bit low. Came down the hill. Never really got out of the block hole, John Crawley. Probably looking for a single to take him to a very good half century.
Beautiful shot. It's just dropped at a fraction short, and Crawley has belted it away through mid-wicket to bring up his half century. Nice way to do it. To bring the scores level. Dominic Cork is coming on now. instead of Philip de Freitas, just the one run needed for victory for Lancashire.
Waiting.
And get it.
Well, something will happen because I can't see Neil Fairbrother blocking out six balls. Dominic Cork doesn't bowl a ball to hit. And then he'll manage to make the winning run somewhere. Very good performance by Lancashire. Maybe a touch of luck in winning the toss and putting Derbyshire in, but they took that opportunity both splendidly yesterday and they batted very well today.
Well, Lancashire's top order really showed its class, though Michael Atherton was an early victim, bowled by Dominic Cork with a real beauty for 10. But then John Crawley, after playing cautiously on the front foot for some time, expanded his stroke play, played quite beautifully off front and back foot, and Neil Fairbrother too, some damaging cover drives, and they saw Lancashire home quite easily, 109 for one wicket. Dominic Cork got that one wicket, but other than Cork and de Freitas, there simply wasn't the experience there in the Derbyshire attack to contain Lancashire within such a short score. And so the result is 108 all out Derbyshire, Lancashire 109 for one, Lancashire winning by 9 wickets. And Wasim Akram was the proud receiver of the trophy on Lancashire's behalf. That might be the first of maybe 3 awards in 1998. We'll keep an eye on that. Ian Austin, man of the match, absolutely accurate, no ball wasted, and his was the nomination of David Gower. And afterwards, David Gower spoke to both those players, as well as to Dominic Cork, the Derbyshire captain.
I suppose it's safe to say nothing much went your way in this game.
No, I need a double-headed coin, I think, but obviously the toss was very important, and I think whoever won the toss was going to bowl, but... Take nothing away from Lancashire, you know, they're a superb one-day outfit, you know, they play well, they work well as a team, and they proved, you know, over the 2 days what a superb team they are, and, you know, good luck to them in the rest of the Championship and the Sunday League too.
They certainly played very well, and very gracious of you to say that. Yet at one stage yesterday afternoon, the opening partnership, you seem to have got over that disadvantage of losing the toss.
Yeah, I think Michael Slater was still a bit high on his sleeping tablets, and Kim Barnett was remembering 1981 too much, but... No, it was a good start, but unfortunately, you know, they plugged back and Peter Martin and Ian Austin polled superbly, and they all did and fielded very well, and we didn't never recover from that.
Whatever, my better luck next time, I suppose, is the answer. Thanks, Dominic.
Okay, thank you.
Well, Wasim, many congratulations. You must be a delighted man.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'm delighted. The whole team is delighted, and I would like to thank the whole supporters who came all the way and stayed and watched us winning the trophy today.
Well, first one in the bag, still a chance of a couple more, you think, this season?
Yeah, we're quite confident we still have a chance to win a couple more trophies, and hopefully we're going to go for it.
Now, Dominic mentioned the toss seemed important, but after that opening partnership of 70 between Slater and Barnett, you must have thought, well, hang on, things aren't quite going our way.
Definitely toss was crucial at that time, but I think when there were 70 for none, ball was doing a bit. I mean, I didn't bowl well, but I think Peter Martin and Ian Austin came back well and won us a game today.
And the batsman today made it look a little bit easier.
Yeah, I mean, John Crawley is playing brilliantly, Neil Fairbrother, everybody chipped in, not just today, the whole year round, and I think it's great goes with the county and the boys all together. Team effort.
Well, well played indeed to you and the team. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Plenty to carry away from this match then.
Yeah, we've suffered a lot before we came down here.
So, what, just?
Just about, yeah. Unfortunate that we couldn't finish it on day one, when sort of obviously a lot of supporters have missed out, so a bit of disappointing for them. But we've come to win the game. Unfortunately, things have worked out well for us.
Well, you've done it in style, you've done it comprehensively. But for you yourself, this has been quite a good month or so. The semi-final at Southampton, during that game, your captain, Wasim Akram, put a very good case forward for you as an international player. England then picked you, you played in the Emirates Trophy, now you're man of the match in this NatWest Trophy final as well.
Yeah, I'm getting a bit dizzy this month, really.
Well, go downstairs if you like. You go back on the grass.
No, it's been an excellent month for me, personally. There's obviously quite a long way to go for the rest of the Lancashire lads for this month, and hopefully this is the first of what won't be the last trophy.
Well, as I say, your career's developing because the county success is here. You've been a focal point of this side for some time now, but also your international career developing this winter as well.
Yeah, I've been fortunate enough to get picked on a tour to Bangladesh. And just see what happens after that.
Okay, well, good luck. And well done today. Congratulations.
Thanks very much.
Well, that ends our live coverage of cricket for this summer. We look forward to bringing you cricket again. And in the meantime, we leave you with a familiar sight from this big end-of-season match at Lord's. The NatWest Trophy firmly in the hands of a Lancashire captain.